Hi guys, welcome to Saulo Ribeiro No Gi Series. In this video, we're gonna take a look at one of the most important aspects of the submission wrestling fight, that is the takedowns. Sometimes the fights get tied on the ground, and what decides the fight is the takedown. I have been using a lot, especially in Abu Dhabi. There is a very stand-up game, and we have to take a look and see the difference between wrestling and submission wrestling. Sometimes in submission wrestling, we back up too much, so we don't have the commitment for start to apply for the takedowns. So the idea is making the guy react before you go straight for the takedown. In wrestling, you always commit to the guy, so you push each other. And in the submission, it's not happened. That's why I need to make him give some react, some respond for me start to attack him. And let's gonna take a look at the first approach when you start the match. So he's gonna reach my head, I'm gonna be reaching his head, and my personal idea is keep a little bit under him. Why? Because I have more level to reach him when I go for the takedown. So my first thing here, I keep my elbow tight in my body to make sure he's not gonna go with the arm under. Yes, and get a better grip for now. So my idea, I always stay protecting my elbow tie here and look straight to him. The first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make it, create a react on him. That's why I'm gonna pull his head a little bit. So when I pull his head, he create a resistance, and that's the time that he give me the opportunity to go for the leg. So I hold, elbow tie, hold the neck, and I make him react. As soon as he react, I drop my way. And instead I go with the right hand, I go with the left hand and pull him to me, okay? I prefer to go always with the hand for outside, because in the most of the time, when I go with my right arm, as soon as he block, he can go apply for the leg and give me a counter attack here. Or, over here a little bit, as soon as I go here, he can go for the rear neck choke and make it harder for me to start to keep him going for the takedown. So in this case, I stay tight, I make him react, and I drop. As soon as I get the leg, I have to make sure that I put my arm and hold. It can be this or can be like this, because now I have the control of the leg. And even if he try to push the leg, push, I still can move with him. And from here, we're gonna start to see which side you're gonna take down and be the most proper takedown.